Finally tonight, last but by no means least, we're going to finish off with a little bit of poetry. And I want to welcome a man here. I'm assured that if I introduce him as Dickie Póc, he won't hit me.
You won't.
No, you won't, I'm assured of that. But he will explain where that came from. It came from the farm, was it?
That's right.
Yeah. So would you welcome, please, Dickie Póc? Here he is.
Well, yes, I'm known as Dickie Póc nearly everywhere. I were not a mere with Dickie Póc in the envelope. I'm quite happy with it because when I get a list of Richard Russell, what I'm that as a bill there. So I'd rather Dickie Póc any day to me. It actually came from the tradition of the Tarbh mountain. Tis Póc and Tarbh, tis where the Schlatter bulls long off when they were building the castle around 1550. And it took about 80 years to build it. That was the tradition that they killed bulls and they used the blood, the hair, the hides, the meat, and God knows them, they used the bullshit as well, it was part of the martyr. Blood, there was no cement at that end. There was not. No, so that's what we call Dickie Póc. Anyway, we won't go into that in detail. I'll just recite a smart little story that they put together about a teacher that they had wanted to take. He was a man who hailed from Billy Shannon, a Teddy Ma, a no-to-no gentleman. And he was very, very good to us all, down through the couple of years we were there. He taught mathematics and woodwork and drawing. He taught us more than that. If he had us going on with bad language outside in the playground, he'd pull us aside and we'd come in. He'd say, lads, you don't have to use that language, you know. You can have a good conversation without it. Wouldn't he right? So I make it as short as possible now. Teddy Ma, and of course, was the Kirkin School I mentioned. When I left Kirkin National School, I went to Bantry Tech on a new bike that was bought for me. It was a 9 mile each way trek. I was but 13 years of age, a country boy so raw, but I was given every confidence there by a man called Teddy Ma. Now this brilliant teacher taught us how he'd do his very best to enlighten us in many things, sure he was overflowing with gist. He also made a firm rule that no nonsense would he take. You were asked to pay attention and at all times stay awake. He taught us mathematics, indeed he taught that subject well. If at first we didn't understand, his patience would not quit. He'd explain his theory over and over, and then would kindly say, if you study hard, you're sure to score, sure wrong was not built in one day. He explained some lovely woodwork skills, and how to tear and sharpen each tool. Each lad was praised for effort done, and never once be called a fool. Well, he didn't tire of his job, at least I never saw him yawning. And he seemed to hit a higher cog and were really exact when teaching drawing. He emphasized in manners, should in day often hear him say, that the lovely words of peace and thanks will take you a long way. Nobody likes the vulgar word, even though to laugh they might, but as little they will think of you when you are gone out of sight. Some students going to school these days, they depend a lot on dread, on laptops and calculators. Some old methods now seem dead, but you couldn't be a verbal word should you hear them all your life, more so if they are said by those whose knowledge is so rife. It is true, past pupils gather to reminisce now and then of the days spent at that Bantry Tech when we were young growing men. They'll all say this together, their words won't have one flaw, to be granted me just one man again, like that brilliant Teddy Ma.
You did.
A man that ran the Boston character for years and years, a right good character altogether. He did long ago. He had a lot of things to say being the postman because he was safe haven prisoners. Help him with the work, and if there was a widow that needed a lot of help, he'd do that. Help in coarse calfing, His name was Sonny Manny. John Manny, of course, would be his proper name. People don't know ever heard of Sonny. And he had a white head of hair. He was a right class man altogether. And he fought having no job with him at all. And it was such something that he agreed with. He did the author, slapped me and said, "Correct, my man." He was known as Correct the Sonny Manny. That to do to explain what he was like. We'll go ahead. There's a white-haired man that we all know well. A little story about him I'd like to tell. A telegram boy accepted his career, so he delivered telegrams far and near. Then he graduated to be a postman through, thus delivering mail to quite a few on a bicycle. Twas the run he made, and his deliveries never were a fake. And along with the mail, sure, he brought the news of the pending marriages, births and deaths, and twas often he spun a lovely story that would lend the saddest sore in it. And on his bicycle, sure, was no surprise to see different forms of merchandise, like a horse of saddle or a bag of flour. He could do it all and did not get sour. Then he was supplied with a lovely van. One would swear to the travelling shop he ran, with poor stuff he brought to people on the mountains, and he was paid with a drop from the copper font. His natural skills were quite good too. He shared his talents with all the neighbours, and whenever a successful job was done, he said he was glad to be able to do the favours. He put rings on souls, he put cars on coals, he castrated bonnets when it was needed, he piped a hay or a garden sprayer for a widow whose husband had life conceded. He shared the sick, laid out the dead, and at the wake, the rosary he well said. He must now have a plea indulgence gained, for all those decades he had well maintained. Sure, I could go on for hours and hours to describe this man that's known to many, but there is no need, for we all know who. Correct, of course, it was Sonny Manny.
Thanks, Dickie. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of the night. Did you enjoy it?
Yes!
I think it was very enjoyable. My sincere thanks to Emilio O'Leary, Dan Hurley, Sean O'Shea, Dan Sullivan, Vincent Crowley, Dickie Póc, and Mary Doyle. Thank you very much for our contribution tonight. Thanks to Noel as well, and everybody here at Bantry Library for affording us this beautiful building here tonight, and to Angela O'Donovan and everybody at Bantry Historical Society. Thank you, Angela, for giving me the pleasure and the honour of doing this here tonight, and I wish you the very best for the remainder of the week, National Heritage Week, and the wonderful work being done by Bantry Historical Society. So, good night, God bless, and of course, have a safe journey home, and keep the tradition in mind. Thank you.
Thank you very much, John, for that. You did a splendid job, as usual. And if you're not all regular listeners to John Green on the radio, you will be from now on. So thank you all for coming. And thanks to everyone who participated here, all the front row people, and to Anthony over for video. I think must be getting turned at this stage. And a special thanks to Noel O'Mahony and his staff for giving us the room here and for all the work he has done and must do yet tonight to prepare and to undo after this. There's a lot of furniture to be moved and a lot of chairs to be stacked and gathered. So thank you very much. I'm almost eating this now. Thank you very much. Thanks to everyone. Stay home.